SARA, welcome back to my channel. Today we are checking out more of AC/DC's Power Up album. The song we are doing today is Through the Mist of Time. We are doing the song and the music video as a request from you guys. And yes, I have tissues on standby. Now, I do want to let you guys know that because of copyright strikes that can happen with music videos, I don't exactly want to confront that. So we are not going to be showing the video on screen. And that is because if you get so many copyright strikes on your channel, you will get your channel deleted permanently from YouTube. And I love my channel and I don't want that. So that's why I don't do music videos at all. And if I do, I again don't do them on screen and I will just react to them. I will count down to when I press play so you guys can watch it at the same time, and we'll do it that way, but I am going to react to the song first as I always do, taking in the lyrics and the music, and then we will take in the music video. But let's stop talking, let's get into it. So you know the drill, like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications of when I upload, and let's get into the music. Okay, we're gonna listen to just the song first. So, if you see me looking this way, it is to see the lyrics. So, here we go.
Sound.
let's talk about the meaning of the song Through the Mists of Time. Now, I think, and I have the lyrics pulled up here, that this song is 100% about Malcolm. And the reason for that is the lyrics of this song. And I think it's talking about how you should treasure the moments you have with everyone you are close with, whether that's musically or not. You know, time waits for no one, and you should really treasure that time you have with the people you are close with. And so he's saying, see dark shadows on the wall, same old pictures, some hang, some fall. And I'm thinking he's saying here that he still sees his brother in his mind, and he still hears his song, he still hears his laugh, he still hears his brother. And then he says painted faces all in a line, and that makes me think of concerts, all in a line. Well, people line up in rows. And so that makes me think of, well, he's thinking back to when Malcolm was in the band before he had to let go. And maybe this is the band thinking back on all the times they spent with Malcolm and having fun, all the rock and roll days, and just having the time of their lives. So again, treasuring those moments. So through the mists of time. Then these lyrics. Monster shadows, a light gone dim. That really hit me and struck a chord with me. It made me think that he's talking about how much he still hears his brother in his mind, still misses him, and of course he does. But he's still with him, Malcolm is. And I say that because Malcolm on the rhythm guitar was a force to be reckoned with. And you could almost classify that as being a monster on the guitar, the monster on that rhythm guitar. He was insane, wow. And Angus, if I remember right, really looked up to Malcolm and really said he was incredible on the guitar. So, a monster shadows, and then if you put a light gone dim, well, after that, Malcolm sadly passed away. So, a light gone dim, his light went dim. So, it's really emotional, and I 100% say this song is about the reminiscing on the good times. With Malcolm, and even though it's very difficult, that's what they're talking about. So, that's what I think. Let me know your opinions on what you think this song is about. Leave it in the comment section down below. Now let's talk about the song itself. This is different for AC/DC, yet it's very brilliant at the same time. You don't really hear sad AC/DC songs. You don't hear a tearjerker from that at all. I think Rudd on the drums hits perfectly as well. And I know that this album is for Malcolm, but this song is so special, and it's something we all wanted and more. I mean, when he passed away, we all wanted that special song for him, and it's incredible that they would do a whole album, and it's top notch. It deserves that Grammy. It truly does. I mean, 100, but then to give him and bless him with this and honor him with a song like this is just so much more of a compliment to him as a person and who he was, and just shows how much he meant to them. and for us as fans, we can use it to remember him by and listen to it and think, you know, this is for you, Malcolm, you know, or whoever we lost in our lives. It's so universal, you know. So this is so beautiful for AC/DC as a remembrance type of song and a treasured moments song. Brian's vocals were so beautiful on this song. Everything was in the perfect spot. I don't think you could change anything in this song. Every note was perfection. The whole song, I don't understand how AC/DC can make such a different type of song for AC/DC and yet make it sound AC/DC. Does that make sense? Like, how can you do that? Like, only AC/DC. That's it. But this song is so pure and beautiful. It truly deserves everything in my heart. Oh, wow. You guys, I'm ready to watch this video. Well, I don't think I really am, but I'm ready. Let's check this out. Okay, you guys, we are going to watch the music video now. So, again, we are not going to show it on camera. I will count down. So when I hit one, I'm going to press play so you guys can press play with me or just watch my reaction. But I will be facing this way. That's where my computer screen is. I do have my tissues. But, I am not ready. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
We'll be right back.
All right, let's talk a little bit about the video and wrap up our thoughts on this song. So, first of all, I want to say that this song is beautiful and an incredible dedication to the band, really, and Malcolm. I think it paid such great respect to the band and its history. So, not only did it have Bon Scott, the original lead singer, but it again had Malcolm in it, of course, because that's who this album is dedicated to. So, and that just emphasizes my thoughts on this song being about Malcolm. I had goosebumps and I was fighting back tears. It was just beautiful. And I noticed some little attention to detail they had that shows even more respect to that history of the band. So they had, of course, the Hell's Bells bell. They had posters up of the Power Up album, but if you looked around it, there were other past albums of theirs surrounding it. There was also other little tiny details in there that I noticed, but that would take up a little more of the video, so we will save that. If you guys want me to make a separate video on that, I can, but it'd be a short video. Now, I think this is one of the most profound songs AC/DC has ever written, and you know, the way it's written and produced and played, matched with the video, feels like a final goodbye and makes you kind of want to cry. It also makes me think about there's going to be a time we don't have AC/DC in our lives, and we're going to look back at this song and be like, you know, this is for AC/DC, and that just hurts my heart. And finally, there's just one last thing I want to say on this topic, on AC/DC in general, before I finish this video, and that is that there was a comment recently about my dad and thanking him for getting me into rock music. And I have to say, you know, to me, rock music is superior. It's the superior music in all of music genres. But, you know, I thank my dad too. I told him about the comment and he had the greatest response, and I wanted to share it with you guys. But, you know, with this, there was a thought I had, and that response he had was the perfect answer to my thought. So AC/DC, it all makes sense here. AC/DC has generations of fans, and there's a reason for that. So like my dad said, it is easy to pass on music when the music is good. So, AC/DC, it's easy for them to be passed on because they are that good. And to me, they are way better than that good. I mean, they are just incredible, but you know what I mean. He's saying that, you know, it's easy to pass on rock music because when the music is good, you don't have to try hard. And that's so true. And it makes me think of AC/DC and why they have generations of fans. It's because their music is that good. And they haven't changed. And that's like what we want and what we like about them. And this album's no different. So, and I know this is my fourth song. I told my dad when he asked me what I wanted for Christmas, and I said the Power Up album on vinyl, because I already know I love this vinyl. And just recently on my doorstep, he bought me it. So I am so excited about it. And I've played it, but only listened to the first three songs, which is the first three songs that we've listened to already. So I haven't listened to the actual full vinyl, and don't worry, I'm not going to, because we're doing that. So this means I can listen to the first four songs because this is the fourth song. But I made a promise to you guys and I keep my promises, so I haven't listened to it and I'm dying to though. But I'm very excited to have that, and you know, that was incredible. Wow. Let me know your guys' thoughts on the song and the video as well. I'd love to hear from you guys your thoughts. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys are staying safe and well, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.